Video. I'm going to talk to you about Penney's game. Penney's game, even though it is played with a coin, is not named after the coin, the penny. It's named after the person who invented this, who kind of discovered this, I guess. Walter Penney, 1969. Getting this information from Wikipedia. I'd come across this before, but never knew it formally, and I did this little programming thing with my intro class, and they really got a kick out of it, so I figured I'd share it. This is not really a game and more of a barroom trick, a wager you can make with someone. And so, you know, the way it works is you actually will flip a coin, but before you start flipping your coins, you ask your, I'm going to refer to as player A, to pick a three coin sequence. So, you know, maybe he'll pick heads, tails, heads, or something like that. And then you know this little rule and you base your pick off of that. But you, and you actually have a much higher chance of winning. I'll explain to you the rule. So if player A picks HHH, then you would pick THH. And the reason for that, the rule works like this, is whatever the middle pick is, and this is, of course, H is head, and tails, T is tails, right? Whatever the middle letter was in their sequence, so in this instance it was H, you pick the opposite of that, and that becomes your first letter. And then the first two that player A picks, they become your next two. So thus the middle T and then HH. And so that becomes your pick. And you actually have a 7-to-1 chance of winning. It's definitely not automatic. It's not guaranteed. So if you're doing this for a wager, you might want to say, let's do the best out of 5 or something like that. You'll be guaranteed, almost guaranteed to win in a best out of 5. It'd be pretty hard. So I should say, though, that the optimal scenario is when player A picks three of the same, like HHH or TTT. That's when your 7-to-1 odds are. If they pick something random, it could be either 3-to-1 or 2-to-1. For instance, if they pick THT, then like you take the opposite of the middle. So T, and then you take the next two. Their first two is your next two. So TTH, that's actually 2-to-1 odds. Still pretty good. The casino would take that, right? You're going to win most of the time. So anyway, this is a little interface that I made in JavaScript. Again, I said I did this with an intro class in high school. They got a kick out. So, you know, the player A sequence is HHH, so I'm going to pick THH. You hit submit, and it actually runs through the sequence, and their player B won, as you would expect. And I'll keep hitting this, and it keeps playing the same, whatever the last sequence was. And we have a tally of how many player A and player B have won. And so the thing with this, if player A, and the reason why, this is kind of the reason why this works, if player A doesn't get HHH as the first three, you're guaranteed a win. Because think about it, for him to get, or him or her, to get HHH, if it's not the first sequence, there's going to be a T that precedes those three H's. And so, thus, player B would guarantee to win in that circumstance. There it is. There's the only chance that player A has if it, the first three come out of HHH. Here we go. Guaranteed a win here. Could take a while, but there we got it. So let me show you how I programmed this. This is in JavaScript. I'm using the canvas in JavaScript. So typical HTML here, you know, your HTML tag, your header tag. I just put a border around my canvas, just a plain black border. Then we got our body tag here. And I put a div in here, and what's in this div is those drop downs. So to create a drop down, you're probably familiar with the select tag that gives you a drop down. You have the option of an H or a T, right? And so, and the important thing here is I gave these IDs of PA1, PA2 for player A, first choice, second choice, and third choice. And then I have player B's picks, and it's identical. I just changed it to PB1. For the IDs, right? And then we have a submit button, and when you click the submit button, it goes to the Penney game method. I'll show you that Penney game method in 1 second, but first there's the canvas that's gonna be filled in with everything. In the, you know, we have our script tag, and the first thing in the script tag is we make a object of the canvas. We get a width and a height. That just seemed like a good one to work, so that in case it was, I made it 1,000 wide in case the sequence took a while to actually find player A or player B sequence. We were had enough room, and I think only once or twice, I did this hundreds of times, did it actually go off the edge of that width. And so then I just keep these player one total, but actually that's player A's total, player two's total is player B's. And so that keeps the total running tab. That's this part here, like player A is 1 and 4, right? And then I have this variable here. This variable here announces the round winner. This shows it to the screen. I'll show you that in a second. While this winner is false, we're gonna keep on running the sequence. I'll show you how that works. This is just a counter, so we know how many times the coin has been flipped in a sequence. This is an array that I keep each coin flip in there so that we can check it. And this is where we have player A's sequences, A, 1, 2, and 3. And I kind of conjoin them together in this one variable, do the same thing for player B. Right? And so now if we look at the Penney game function that gets called as soon as we press the submit button. So the first three lines here, we are just collecting whatever was in the value of the dropdown. So that would be whatever these were, right? In this instance, it was HHH. And then I combine it together so that I have just one variable, so it's easier to work with. So PA holds all three of those characters. Then we do the same thing for player B. So winner is equal to false, so that way we keep flipping the coin, and when we get to a winner, then we'll change that to true. I just reset my array and reset the counter to 0. Actually, I don't need to do that twice. And this just in the draw method, this is everything that's going to show to the screen inside the canvas. First, we just create an empty rectangle that kind of clears the screen. Then I fill it, and that's that color pink rare. You can choose any color you want. And so, yeah, like I said, the winner, we have it equal to false here. And so we're going to keep going into this if statement. We're producing a random number. This is going to produce a random number, either a 0 or a 1. And I designate it 1 for H. Otherwise, if it's a 0, it's going to be a 2. And then we just keep adding them to this the spots string variable. And what that does is that's how we show it to the screen. So that's a this right here. That's what's showing to the screen there, right? And I don't compare anything until we get at least 3 different coin flips. Because otherwise, we don't have enough to start comparing yet, right? Because it has to be at least 3. So there's my counter that's keeping track of the coin flips. And then we just, so the spots array, we kind of add that to the spots total variable. So that now that I can just do this simple if statement. So if PA is double equal to spots total right here, then we have the player A has 1, so I can announce that. And the winner variable is equal to true, so that we will stop going into this if statement until we hit submit again, right? And then we increment player 1's total so that we're keeping track of the who's won more often, right? And same thing for player B. This is simply just printing things to the canvas, right? So the first thing we're printing is the actual sequence of the coins being flipped, then the round winner, like, and that's actually who wins that particular round that you're in, and then this is just showing the total wins between player B and player A. That's it. That's all the code. And, you know, this is actually just setting your interval. Like, if I wanted to make it a little slower, I could put this like 1,000 is a second. So every second, then it will flip a coin, right? And so if we go in here and I hit submit, it's going to go a little slower than it did last time. Let you just see it. Wow, getting a lot of T's there. Well, there we go, player B1. That's it. I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope you like the whole Penney game probability scenario. Thanks.